All right, guys. Filibuster here, back with another European Tier 7 Battle Cup. I think these guys are Tier 7. Might be Tier 8. I think it's Tier 7, though. We've got watching the Minecraft Maniacs. Not sure whose idea that name was, but whatever. It's got Silent, aka Akash. Got Sparkart, aka Sliv. We got Deffy, aka Deffy the Little Bitch. We got Baron. And we've got Dreamcore, aka Memecore, in the house. On the other side, we got Don't Ban Techies. Pretty stupid name. Because you should obviously ban techies. We got some bitches on that team. We don't even care about them. They are, however, first banning Ricky. Something else here soon, whereas the Minecraft Maniacs first banned Pangolier, despite having a Pangolier player on their team, and the Visage. Not a big fan of Visage either.
Dire team band.
Tuskar banned for the Radiant. Very interesting. Shout out to Bullet Bourbon.
10 seconds remaining.
Especially at 2 o'clock. Very good.
5 seconds remaining.
Got a third and final ban. Reserve time being used. Probably banning the Dark Willow here, I think. Unless they want to pick it, but they don't get first, or they do get first pick. So maybe they want to pick it. But if they don't want to, I assume they will ban it here. This is the semifinals, by the way. The Dark Willow is banned, as predicted. So they are not looking to go to the Willow. I would imagine. Let's see, I'm not sure who's playing what. I would imagine it's Sliv and Dreamcore playing the supports.
10 seconds remaining.
So I really, 5 seconds remaining. Really don't know what they're gonna go. Ricky Maru first banned. That's so funny. If not, Dire would definitely be taking it.
Dire team pick.
Naga Siren first or last ban, I should say, for the Radiant. Pretty crazy.
Radiant team pick. Witch Doctor.
Witch Doctor first pick. Is that Dreamcore playing yet, I wonder? Not sure who they have playing. Witch Doctor is such a powerful hero. The cask is just absolute decimation, and Maledict hurts the entire game.
5 seconds remaining. Radiant team pick.
Clockwork, a classic counter to the Witch Doctor. Not sure if they'll run at 4 or 3 position offlane. It's pretty versatile either way.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Giving the second pick a lot of thought. I generally try to pick a either another support or an offlaner here. Although if you want to pick like a mid Viper or something, you could totally pick
Dire
it.
Team pick.
Disruptor. So Witch Doctor's probably not gonna get many ulties off. Very tough Witch Doctor game already. Those are two very good picks right there as well for the Radiant.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
I would almost just fucking drop a Viper here and just say, come at me. They played him last game. Might not want to play him again, but Viper's pretty domination. Very good against those heroes. Natural 4 staff carry against Clockwork. Very tanky as well. Good against magic damage, which both of those heroes are pure magic damage, essentially. They might just not want to play Viper again, though. Slardar, so picking the second support. I say that, but I feel like we were in Slardar carry the other day. Was that us? Not sure.
Dire team ban.
But I could definitely see that coming out. Viper would be such a good pick here. I wonder if they'll ban it out. They banned the Lifestealer out, so Radiant did, so I would assume they're not trying to pick the Viper. Morphling ban. I haven't seen much Morphling. Always a very scary hero, though. Giving this pick a lot, or ban a lot of thought. They will have first pick after the next ban from the Dire.
Dire team ban.
Juggernaut, very good ban, very overpowered hero. Anti-mage ban, very good anti-mage ban, hell yeah. I hate seeing anti-mage.
Dire team pick.
Enigma, going for the big team fight. Been seeing a lot of Enigma lately. Basically a hero that can always get something in the offlane. I mean, very difficult as a support. Not only shutting the Enigma, like you can shut the Enigma out of the lane, but getting the Enigma out of the two jungle camps closest to their lane, that's a different story, because you got those Edelons to deal with. They're not weak early. I mean, they are to AoE, but can't do much against that. Slardar won't be able to fight him out. Just focus him with the Edelons. He'll have to run. Witch Doctor. I feel his level 2 cask at level 3. Is it 4 bounces? Is it 4 for the level 2? I feel like it's like 5 or 6 even. What the hell is.
By my bones.
4. It is 4. Okay. 6 for level 3. So yeah, even a level 2 cask, they're just gonna get lost in the other ones. So down to 9 seconds total time for the Minecraft Maniacs.
Radiant team pick.
A lot of thought being put in. Getting the Sand King as well. Interesting. So they're trying to out team fight the Radiant right now. Both sides have such an early clock on them right now. We'll see how late. I guess it'll be a wagering game on how late he's ready to go in these last picks. Radiant still has a minute 12 of reserve time. Dire's at 4 seconds.
Dire team pick.
Quick pick.
Slark.
Slark. Oh my god, they're trying to give him the game. So Slark, a fucking dog shit hero right now. And honestly, not that good against this team. Faceless Void, very good pick here. Good against Slark, good against all their heroes, really, and secures a lot more team fight. Fights around the Chrono are going to be pretty interesting with the SK and the Slaughter kind of trying to all be on top. Like, right now, they got everyone trying to be on top of each other against an Enigma and a Disruptor and a Clockwork. So these fights could go pretty bad for the Dire without some good spacing. And if I were them, I would like almost assuredly pick a Viper mid right now. I think that brings this team together. Very good against all their heroes. Will allow Void to get some farm.
10 seconds remaining.
Will allow whatever offlane combo Dire's trying to work here. I'm not sure what they're trying to do with it. What are they trying to do? It's very like hard to counter pick too. I just pick the Viper here. You got plenty of control. He's gonna be able to do a lot. You'll get rid of Slark's passive.
10 seconds
which is
remaining.
Huge with that silence. No matter, you can't dispel it either.
5 seconds remaining.
I think you just pick the Viper here. Are they gonna random the last pick? Okay. 1 second, 2 seconds. Queen of Pain, also a very good pick. Kind of tough to play against the Disruptor, but right now I like their team. However, very, very easy pick to counter. I wonder if they just go the classic Puck here. Puck's pretty legit against the Dire. Would definitely put a clock on the Radiant though, because Slark cannot carry a Void alone, especially not against Quap and Void. You got a minute to think about it. They could also go Viper. That would be a pretty good pick for them. Although the Slardar Invoker. This is gonna be a really good game. Both of these teams have crazy team fight. Everyone's got damage. Everyone's got mobility. I mean, just look at the mobility here. Blink, Time Walk, Stun, Blink, probably Force Staff, Sandstorm, Sprint, Blink. Witch Doctor is going to have a glimmer, but other than that, damn, that's a nice set dream. Oh, yeah. Mobility here as well, or at least maybe even counter mobility right here. Counter mobility, blink, it all sucks bullshit. You got, if he goes Quas Wex, or even later on, even if he doesn't go Quas Wex, you got the Ghost Walk, and then you've got ulti, probably a Force Staff here with the clock. So these are going to be action-packed games. I'm going to take this time to just pour a little dab of whiskey. Shout out to Bullet Bourbon once again. Scouting Sunstrike already. Got 6 spectators. Ooh. Let's get our last hits and denies ready. Oh, we gotta take this off. Free camera. Okay. Got 6 tangos and observer. Oh, it's check out who's playing what here. We got Sliv on Slardar with a Orb of Venom, Observer and Sentry, and a Stout, so playing support, would assume. Could be offlane, I suppose. We've got Dreamcore with an Observer Ward on the Witch Doctor, Tango's Clarity. We've got Defi mid Quap with 2 shared Tangos, a Null, and Tangos of his own. So probably gonna get harassed out, or he's expecting to get harassed out by the Invoker. They can't really rotate that much to help them. I mean, Disruptor kind of can, but Clock can't really early, so might not need that much regen. We've got Silent playing offlane Sand King, so I think it is the offlane Sand King. Stout Shield Tango's probably gonna be solo. I don't know about this Orb of Venom Stout against a Clockwork offlane. Oh, it's gonna be Enigma though, right? Because Clock's support. Right, right. Definitely good then, because he'll be able to man up against the Enigma. And we've got Varen on the Void. The six Tango's probably gonna get a Quelling Blade. He's also disconnecting. So I would assume he gets a Quelling Blade and a Stout. Has to get a Stout Shield in that lane. Otherwise those Elans will just tear him up. Dire in general is going to have to make some plays as well. How's it, everyone? This is Iron the One here today. We're killing some zombies. Whatever the fuck that is. Muted. Had one of their guys muted last game. Pretty funny. So I think everyone's ready. If only they could go. Oh my god, who cares, people? Who cares? Let's do it. Let's fucking do it, boys. I better not hear all that shit from both sides, will I? So we've got Sentry going offlane on the Sand King. See who wins the early warding battle. I think that helps so much determining who's going to win the lanes. Who's winning the early warding battle. We've got an Observer ward from Enigma blocking the camp. Kind of risky because they'll see that it's blocked. Sliv coming out of here, Observer and Sentry. Will bypass his vision if he runs up like this. Let's see what they're thinking.
30 seconds to battle.
They'll probably want to invade. Void spotted. Gosh, with the Sentry, so it looks like both sides are gearing up to invade. Backing off, sinking, thinking about backing off. Yeah, he's backing off too. Both teams, two bounties to start. About standard. Server placed up here. Wonder if Enigma spotted that or not. Find out here. Ward down. We'll see if Akash decides to use the sentry before or after he dies. It is going to be a tough time surviving this lane. And he uses it before. What a player. What a player. Easy 100 gold. Oh, both offlaners dewarding the enemy's first lane ward. Baby. See what Invoker ended up going with. Yeah, the Wraith Band. I think that's pretty standard, right? Oh, top, got some action. Enigma getting. Oh, yeah, nice. Alright, Witch Doctor went around. In jumps the Void. Enigma trying to juke. Won't be able to juke, and that'll be first blood. Getting some Edelon treats here is Sliv. Enigma trying to juke with the Edelons. And it looks like Sliv will only get one. Still, very good first blood. Slark with seven denies. What? That's painful. I mean, even if you're in XP range, this is not going to get any. Yeah, look at that. Half half XP from two waves. Just because Slark had seven denies. Crazy. So Slark off to the early lead. Oh, got a little battle over here. Akash feeling constantly threatened by the enemy supports. The standard safe lane meta right now, or I should say off lane V safe lane meta, but he does get it, and he should get the second one. Does he have stun? He doesn't have anything skilled yet. He's got stun skilled. He's going to steal it and make good play, baby, good play. Oh, and he wants the DD. Go for the DD. He has no idea the DD is there, unfortunately. Or he does, but he just opted not to go for it. I thought he had vision there. Disruptor getting it instead. That might end up hurting. Enigma has the lane back here. Level 3 already. That is just Enigma offlane right there for you. Enigma offlane. Got Slaughter lining up for a gank on the Invoker. Wave's in a pretty good spot. Should be able to pull it off. Oh, pause. Comes out again. St. T.I., folks. So apparently a general feeling of lag on the dire. Look at this. 13-14 for the Slark, 11-5 for the Invoker, versus a 9-3 for the Void, and a 6-1 for the Quap. Early advantage. Only reason showing under 1k, I think, is because of the first blood. What the fuck? Come on, go when ready. Y. G. Nice, someone presses F9. Alright, are they gonna resume the gank on mid? Lane at a less favorable position now? That's so hard to hit against the fucking Invoker. Yep. Even with the dagger. Oh my god. Painful. Definitely spawn. Getting a couple here, a couple there. Probably not gonna get. Oh, he. At least he got the XP for it. That being said, gold's not only an issue, but experience. We still got Sand King at, you know, half a level basically. Meanwhile, almost level 4 on the Enigma. That is. That's something else right there. That's how you get advantage out of the laning phase right there. Akash just desperate for any sort of farming opportunity whatsoever. Still have a level 1 disruptor though, so I think this is worth it for them. Even though the Enigma's getting off easy. And by easy, I mean like. Level 4 at 4 minutes on any offlaner in this meta is pretty, really good. That being said, we do have boots, and I bet he tries to save up for the mana boots, but we'll see. Nope, he's going probably soaring, trickle boots into the soaring. On top of it, a little skirmish going on, and maledicted, but he got some TP support. Sliv, what you gonna do, buddy? What you gonna do? Oh, he's gonna run up. He can eat one tree, I think, and get out. No, he's TPing. Good TP. And he'll get out. Very nice. So, two rotations forced. Unfortunately, oh man. We got a level 2 on sinking here, but he is away from the lane. He could just really be bullying the Slark right now. So, he does have Sandstorm. No caustic to come up and bully. Void trying to get everyone out of his lane. He has a tri lane against him. Might not be the best. We'll see what Sand King can do to catch back up. Is it worth your life? Chased out by the Slark. Yeah, missed Sentry. Ooh, the damage though. Sand King trying to dodge it. Oh, we got a skirmish up top. Maledict and stun on the Enigma. That is an easy way to get kills right there. And if you're the Enigma, you just can't run up like that. Nope. Saying there's a ward up there, but there is not a ward up there. It's just a sentry. The ward is, in fact, Gretchia. Slave Andrian looking to make a rotation, both level 2, so they can definitely kill between the two of them. Is Disruptor going to get caught out? He spots the two of them. Dream not realizing that he's seen the whole time by the ward up here. So they're just wasting time right now. Enigma with the Soul Ring. Level 4 still. Meanwhile, same thing, level 2. Going on the Clockwork. Might get caught out here. Clockwork's got the call. It's burning his mana. Sinking's got no mana left. Quap's got to be careful here. She's got no cooldown, so unfortunate. Haste rune from the Quap. Very unfortunate rune for the Clockwork. And one more hit. Oh, one more because of the salve. And that's a very worth rotation from the Queen of Pain. Meanwhile, we got 45 for 32 on the Slurk. 32 denies. Holy moly. Sand King getting some much needed XP here. 42 for 13 on the Invoker, 31 for 13 on the Void, and only 27 for 1 on the Queen of Pain. So not able to get many denies mid. Worthy tribute. We got a pool coming out here for Dream Core. Forcing the Invoker back. And Sliv wanting to get up on the Enigma here. Still can't though. Like, you see how much damage that did? All of those things could just, like, four hit him at this point. He could leech XP, sure, but he might not be able to do much. Oh. It's one, two. Oh, he might actually be able to get a couple. Loses a lot of health for it though. But, yeah, that might actually be worth it for the Sawyer, just because you want that extra gold. We got a sentry. Are they going to put another sentry up there? They should know it's not warded. He's asking his team. Should I put a sentry here? No, put it in lane. I think it's here. Maybe it's over to the right more. I don't really want to waste it. Oh. No, he's just waiting for the bounty, actually. So I feel like there's a lot going on already on both sides. Sinking up to level 4. No level in caustic, huh? Is that the build? I guess you really, it's too late to really force the Slark out, so I guess you're just giving up at all getting caustic. I don't mind getting that. Yep, meanwhile we get the Slardar going down the Clockwork. Anytime the clock catches the Slardar, you can really kill him. I mean, that's a very tough play, Slardar against Clockwork. Very tough. So he's got the Midas, treads on Slark. That's scary. It's a lot of attack speed. Very, very scary. Enigma denying those range creeps. Has Black Hole ready. No level in Midnight Pulse. I think that's kind of standard. Got no mana boots, so you really aren't relying on having that mana around. Or I should say this mana. It's only 95 level 1. It's pretty good. I might actually consider getting a level on it. If you can get that down before Black Hole, it's crazy. It's also really good for stopping any sort of pushes that you have going on. Alright, so let's take stock of where we're at here and the farming numbers. How is it only a 1k advantage, I wonder, for the Radiant with those lopsided last hit numbers? I guess the 3-1, maybe just lost a lot of unreliable gold in their three dust, the Radiant did. Which would make sense. They only have one kills worth of reliable gold at the moment. Pings to go on top. Baron hitting the Chrono. Maledict on the Enigma. Not getting ready for the stun. Pretty risky backing up and not being ready for the stun. Very crazy. Guess Enigma, you know, has what he has, but who the hell knows. So a very good kill for them. Chrono down, but it means the Enigma is dead. They can secure bounty runes and look to continue getting some good farm on the board. Another pause, man. For the love of fucking Jesus. Switch over to net worth. Tells a much closer story there. Very much closer. Slark only at 800 in front of the Void. Void is looking real good here. Looking real, real good. Let's see what he has. Treads 2200. What the hell is this guy gonna go? I don't know if they want to do the Battle Fury. I mean, Battle Fury is kind of standard, but it just doesn't quite seem like a Battle Fury kind of game. Personally, I'd go the Maelstrom, but not a lot of people like going that. Straight up, at least. Three Norwegians, one Hitler, and one Ukrainian. Might as well be Russian. So four Russians and a German, huh? So 10.5 minutes in. 10.5 minutes in. Like 30. Void's gotta be a little bit careful here, because Enigma does have Black Hole ready to go.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
It's really got no big fight. Kind of boring on this game, to be honest. No TP's in, no dives, no nothing, just a bunch of last hitting. But, you know, it's how the Europeans do it. They just, you know, take their time with shit. You know, just play little slap fights with each other. Putting their big boy pants on and getting work done. But it's okay. I'm sure they'll get there eventually. Sliv, now to level 6, or it's like, Silent. Okay, Akash, up to level 6. Almost level 7, so he's catching up very nicely. Enigma at level 7, almost 8, still level advantage, but that's to be expected. It's still a very good job from SK catching up with that. Got Raindrops and Trinkle Boots completed on the level 4 Slardar, so he needs some levels badly. I almost feel like they should rotate with the next Chrono. He is going to Battle Fury. Okay. I guess it's pretty standard. Pretty, we got level 4 on the Witch Doctor too. Looking to make some shit happen. Slark with the DD, that's fucking scary. Almost the Echo Saber, which is 200 gold away. That is even scarier. Slark's getting big. Very big. Plus, once this Disruptor gets level 6 as well, it's gonna be really interesting to see what this team fight. I feel like Radiant wants to team fight now, and Dire wants to team fight in about 10-15 minutes. But I feel like Dire's gonna get baited into team fighting now, and they're gonna get fucked for it. We'll see how they do in this tier 1 down here. Got Clock down below, no scan. Ooh, Akash with the sneaky. Stop short. Oh, but then he walks into the cogs, Akash! Brutal. Invoker's doing his thing over here, so two Midases on the Radiant on both of their cores. Actually, does Enigma have one?
Radiant's bottom tower
is, what the fuck build is this? Ring of health, gloves, and headdress? Where the fuck is he going? Oh, we got a fight coming up here. Disruptor getting chased by the Slaughter. Slaughter really wanting the kill. Slaughter asking for help. Raptor might be getting the help instead, and that was not the glimpse. No rotations out of mid yet. We got a Veil of Discord on the Queen of Pain. Very nice. Let's see if he tries to make a play with it. Enigma has Black Hole up still. What the hell is this item build? Oh, Helm of the Dominator, isn't it? Yeah, isn't it the Helm of the Dominator? Fuck. Yeah, it is. Okay. Okay, that's what it is. So he's gonna have a bunch of creeps. Vision maintained from both teams on the top lane though. So they're staying there. 14 have been, and we have 7 total kills in the game. I thought we were about to see some shit at the start of this. Instead, we're seeing not shit. So I'm very disappointed in both teams at the moment. Teams have their carry down bot. Oh, jump that up. Oh, waits for power, doesn't it? Play a Chrono. I was gonna say, if you're Void, now you can start picking on the guy, especially with like Battle Fury. One bash, be doing third of Slark's HP. Ooh, Clockwork setting up for the counter kill. They play it in though, they need to bait the lead before they can actually go on him. Meanwhile, Enigma. Oh. Dream Core, looking for the wrap. Enigma's still vulnerable. They're pinging. They're going for him. There's the Black Hole coming out. Black Hole coming out. Oh, but the baby's so real. Ah, oh, Sinister comes in. Kills the Star Guard. Dream Core with excellent execution, though. Dropping everything, not risking it, and making sure that they get killed. Which is good, because they wouldn't have gotten it. Meanwhile, the Invoker gets gone on mid, so he pays the price for using a Sinstrike top. I wonder if they went on him while he was distracted. That would truly be Space Creator, if that were the case. Slith back top, getting the lane for himself now, needs that level 6 desperately. Dream's level 8, but Slith needs that level 6. Corrosive Haze, mad damage. Quap going in on the Slark, not getting shit done. Void missing as well. Oh, deciding to dive instead of going on the clock. Giving Enigma time, Enigma no Black Hole. They can go on the Enigma, can't they? They choose not to. Ooh, and Void takes some burn. Only level 1 cogs, though, it looks like. Yep, level 1 cogs. So starting to get some action. That's what we're here for. Take a look at the net worth graph. We went up to 3k briefly for Radiant, or almost 3k I should say, and now we're heading back down to about even, I would say. And XP, which was even more pronounced, 6k, back down to 2k. So Dire have definitely brought this game back. Once Slaughter gets some levels, yep, doing this, he can just spam that. Force Slark to use his Dark Pact. Dark Pact there, strongest spell. And in fact, you can set up. Oh, Enigma with the Sunstrike. Oh, poor Slaughter. At least they're using that to like try to kill a support. That's pretty wasteful. Slark going in from behind though. That will not be wasteful. Or is it? A lot of action up here. Both teams coming in. Void comes in, wants to use the Chrono, doesn't use the Chrono instead. Both teams facing off. We got Slark, or we got a Clockwork and a Disruptor looking to wrap. Clock going on them. Are they going to get the glimpse? The Chrono. Big Chrono actually going on the Disruptor. Can't glimpse. He's got time to kill the Disruptor. Ooh, Disruptor will be down though. He can get out of it and time walk back, so they're going to turn on the Enigma. They get the Enigma too. Clock on the way out. Can they get the clock as well? Big 3 kills here it would be. Clock hooking out to the neutrals and the TP. It's going to be enough, isn't it? Very nice. Very nice. So saves another kill. Meanwhile, ooh, Dire Courier goes down though. Not even sure where that is. Dream getting some XP mid, so it does seem like it was about an even trade. I don't. Definitely could have been better for both sides. I've got Void looking for his next big item. It's going to be a Shadow Blade. I guess that. Okay. I mean, I guess with the Battle Fury, you get one gimme item, I guess. And so you can use that to basically, like, a drums or any sort of other item, like a good positioning item, like Sange or Yasha. Shadow Blade. Interesting. Ooh, he's diving me, Nathan. Voice. Getting Black Hole and Sunstruck. Oh my god, what a throw. Same thing going in. They don't have protection, though. Dream getting caught out. He's going to have to TP. Oh, he dodges the hook, and he almost gets out of there, but he doesn't instead. He creates space for Sand King to get out. And I'm not sure about that dive. Dive seemed pretty crazy. Voker is just doing whatever the fuck he wants, man. Scepter's got so much shit right now. Oh, my God. Two levels on Deffy here. Deffy still has... Ooh, he's got Yules, but he can't get it because of the courier death. Sliff coming down the river. Oh, but... Oh, he fucked his blink up. That sucks. That happens sometimes. Okay, he's going for Steph now. I was going to say, going blink, I guess, is... It's always good if you can get there, but having a four Steph this game against the Clockwork is going to be big. Enigma running away. Oh, Sliff, no. Oh, no. So close. That was good juke by Enigma. Good juke by Enigma. Dream Core checking for some enemy vision. Got none. Trying to put some down of his own. Get spotted by the Radiant Ward if he does. Maybe not. Let's see if he does. Oh, he does get spotted. Oh, and it's not in range. Brutal. So Radiant will continue having good vision here. Void's going a Mask of Madness now. This is one squishy fucking build, man. I guess we get a good chrono off. We're gonna kill someone first. Ooh, and they get a most likely glimpse. Big fight going on. Slark's going down. This is good for the Dire. Void's coming in. Void has Chrono. They want to make a big play here. They're getting ready for it. Oh, Void's got a 4-man Chrono. Void's going to do it. He uses the 4-man Chrono. Same thing. He's getting ready. He's allowed to shut up. He's getting ready for it. He stuns it, but he does an ulti first. Oh, he didn't even have ulti. The Disruptor ulti is going to counter. Oh, they didn't have their big spells up. What else? The Disruptor ulti. Oh, but the Quap comes in and just loads them up. That's a full-on team wipe. Witch Doctor's coming back up from earlier. And that's what we call sexy time right there. Dire making the plays. Making those plays. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Very good. Even without the sinking ulti. I'm not sure where he used it though. I missed him using it. And Dire will claim a tier 1 mid. So let's check the gold lead after this tower. I'm just gonna add a substantial amount to it. Actually, not that much because the nerf will add only, what, 500 and I guess 600 net worth. Let's take a look. Very good. Very good chunk. They had gotten it back up to about 4k here before that fight. XP's finally in the Dire's favor for the first time this game. Definitely showing the shifting winds. Dire looking to keep the pressure on. This is not ideal for the Slark. Slark going the BKB. Still not the best item. I mean, like, you get the BKB and you got a Slardar. You can get on top of you with the blink. And, you know, still Corrosive Haze you. I guess the BKB is still pretty good against Slardar. I mean, you got his Bash to worry about. You got Void's Bash to worry about. You have Void's Chrono to worry about. You got Death Ward. Oh, they're spotted. Oh, this is so bad for the Dire. They're about to give it all back. Oh, the Invoker with the Tornado, Meteor, Meatball. Ah, Witch Doctor's dead already. Sinking, trying to get the fuck out. Black Hole coming in. Oh my god, but the Quap gets out. It's only the Sinking caught in it. That's really big. Quap's got to go one more blink before he can TP out safely. He TP's out now. Oh, Vision's not there. Beautiful, beautiful blink. And that's a wasted ward. Could have been a lot worse. Actually, could have been one kill worse, but still a pretty big kill. Pop getting out of that black hole by the skin of his teeth. Wards being thrown everywhere. How many wards does Radiant have right here? Very, very paranoid warding. Actually, that observer is about to go down, so this is kind of worth, I suppose. Holy moly. Void creeping up there, about to pass the Invoker for the first time all game. Good signs for the Dire. He wants to get the deny. Oh wait, no, it's the kill. It's the 125 gold right there. That's the dominated catapult. Ooh, was it bait though? Are they lulling the Void into a sense of security? They are. Tornado coming in, Meatball coming in from the Invoker. Deafening Blast, but he jumps out of it, and the Malefice cannot go on quick enough. Void's turning around to Invis. Slark catching the Slardar, though. Perfect positioning from the Slark catching reinforcements. Void still wants to go. I'm not sure this is the play. He chronos the Slark. Is he going to kill him in time? He's not going to kill him in time. He's, in fact, going to die himself. Oh, the fucking Disruptor ulti canceling the same thing. Oh, this is a bad fight for Dire, or is it? How are they winning this fight? Oh my god, Clock trying to get out. Clock coming in with the hook. Man, there's shit happening everywhere. Radiant turning this fight after all. Urn getting the kill on the Disruptor. 4-for-2 trade so far. Not the best fight for the Dire. That looked bad the whole way down, and I'm not sure how it didn't happen worse. But Radiant has pulled it back. They are pushing, getting a T2 tower, and that should be, yep, see the gold swing happen. Very, 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 very swing. And what we're seeing is just a squishy Void dying. I mean, I guess he's gotta go BKB now, but does that help with the pure damage Sunstrike? I think we still get Sunstruck through the BKB, right? But it's pure damage, right? So you should be able to. Where's this fucking hero at? Can I... Shit. We'll wait to see when he invokes it. Oh! Alacrity. Never mind. Has he even died? I don't think the Invoker's died. He's died twice. Doesn't seem like it. Enigma's died 7 times. Not a good game for that offlane Enigma. Did his part at the start, but hasn't really done much since. That black hole right here was just split second late. I don't know if he didn't have mana. It looked like he had even Soul Ring. I'm not sure. Invoker has the blink down. Shivas. Oh my god. That's scary. Roche has not gotten down yet. No Invoker big refresher orb combos coming up. No Chronosphere refresher orb combos coming up either. Or Black Hole. Ooh, Radiant trying to make a play. They're smoked up. We got Slark in the front looking for anyone. Do they see him? They're pinging up there. They don't see him. Oh my god, we got another pause off in this game. I just want to fucking die. Why are we paused, guys? Come on. Shout out to Bullet Bourbon for getting me through these pauses. One of them's raging, dude. I bet they're all trying to calm him down. That was definitely a game plan pause right there. Dire all grouped up on the high ground. Smoke looks like it's about to be wasted. And they're indeed showing. Clock still smoked, looking for something happening. I'm not sure about this Void engagement. This is crazy as fuck. Oh my god, they see him. They don't see him. Oh, they do see him. It's a tornado. Does he know he's blinking out the Void? Shit, a brick. Oh, is the glimpse going to come through? Nope, it's not. Damn. I would have glimpsed it. Void doesn't have BKB. He would have died. Getting BKB, though. So maybe they didn't know. Caster's vision, I guess. Got a ward going off in the Radiant here. Sentry seeing it already. Akash looking for the surprise. Some beautiful placement from him. They have no idea he's here. And he can access both big fighting positions. Looks like it's gonna set up. We got the Witch Doctor cast coming out. Void bashing. Witch Doctor ulti already used. Swept ulti down there. They're not gonna get the Void. You can't do anything about that. Void dead. That's why I don't know about the initiation. Sinking stun going nowhere. His ulti's down. Slaughter is dead. That is a terrible fight for the Dying. And it's because the Void can't do shit without dying if he's the one in the ship. They just have so many ways of locking him down. Even with the BKB. Number one being. Oh, the ice wall into the sun strike is just the nastiest shit ever. Black hole getting the sink, and sink doesn't have it all though. I'm not sure that's the black hole target they wanted. Void coming in. Void doesn't have any good targets, getting stunned. What's he gonna do? Just going looking. Nothing. Oh, we've got the pop coming out here. We're gonna zoom off this one a bit. We got a two-man chrono. Slark spotted, Slark dead. Void gonna get hit with everything though. He's got no mana, he's gonna die again. Oh my god. That is like the fourth death in a row on Void. This is not looking good for the Dire. Radiant's just gonna come through here. Aggressive blink from the Invoker going on the Slark. Are no fear being shown from this Invoker. And a glyph coming out from the Dire. Ooh, Drin trying to catch you. I never got Enigma getting out though. Blink not quick enough from the Slaughter. Tornado coming in. They still want to go. I just don't think the Dire can capitalize on it just yet. Oh. Sinking, stuns to the creeps, trying to push out the lanes. Still no Force Staff. I probably would have gone Force Staff before that Evils. I think they're not respecting the talk enough. Slaughter going in, trying to stop killing the Shrine, but I think he's just going to give him his life. Or do they? It's a huge fight. Do they get the Invoker? If they can get the Invoker right here, it's going to be a good fight. Invoker going down. That's the way to do it. Okay. Link out from Enigma just in the nick of time. That is crazy. Still chasing the Fokker. They're going to get the Fokker, but Enigma should just get the hell out of dodge here. Doesn't. Goes in for the Malphist. They're going to re-engage. Slark. Forgot about the Slark. He's got his BKB. Sand King trying to run away. Oh, is he going to run away? I don't think he's going to run away. Glimpse. Kicks out of it. Yep. Stun. Oh. Nope, not going to be enough. Sand King going down. So, we're going to take a look at the graph here, and this is definitely three lost team fights. I think that's how you accurately affect three lost team fights on the graph. Because that's what we have right now. And a lot of it can be solved with the Void BKB, which we are halfway towards. We're going to have to figure out a way to get Void this BKB, because he desperately needs it. Disruptor, almost has Glimmer, definitely nowhere near the Scepter, so Void BKB is going to be really good here for at least 1.5 minutes. Shout out to Bull Bourbon once again, making a perfect whiskey. Koros, the Invoker. Oh, so you just pop up like that? Did I just pop up? I feel like I did two pop-ups there. Or two zoom outs, I should say. So we got Radiant Doom with our Shan. Looks more like just trying to bait a fight more than anything. Dire probably saying that they can't fight. Okay, so there's one. I got there too. Slark with a Scythe of Vice. Huh? That is a lot of gold. He's saying fuck his boots to save the life. So then you want to switch out the Midas that greed or fuck. He's saying fuck his boots. Whatever. So I'm assuming Radiant's going to want to push with this. They don't necessarily need it to farm. And I think they got a clock on them. Although, this lack of BKB in the Void is just... Until he gets it, they can pretty much fight. I mean, there's not a hero on the Dire that is gonna get focused, so like Void is the only target. Like if the Radiant kills the Void, as long as they're not all grouped up for a massive Witchdock ult, which is easy to stun, a Sand King ult, which, you know, that's their biggest threat at this point. He is level 3 ulti, so that's gonna be a lot of damage there. If he can land it. He hasn't really landed one yet. But this is just gonna be some out here, I think. I need to watch these fights here. Give the up close and personal feeling.
Radiant's bottom tower is under
until we have to fight. Oh, and they're going on the Void. There's three people down here. Are they going to be able to get the Void? Detect. Those got the detect coming in. This is fucking scary. Oh, they're right on him. And he gets spotted. Circle and glimpse. Your circle gets vision. There it is. Oh my god. Oh, he wants the chrono. Is it big enough? Oh, Thar's coming in! We got the Sand King ulti! Sand King's gonna throw them down afterwards! They kill them all! The bait from the fucking Void is massive! Oh my god! He's spawning. Is the Slark? Slark's gonna turn. Slark's got the sheep on the Void. Is he gonna be able to tank the Witch Doctor ulti? It doesn't look like he is. Void's getting away. Void's trying to re-engage. Oh man, they're gonna back. Black hole coming out from the Enigma! Oh, the Slark and the Enigma can do it. They're killing the Witch Doctor. They're killing the Sand King. It just keeps going back and forth. We got the Quap coming in. Quap's coming on the roller. Is it gonna be enough for just Quap in Slarker? I don't know. Now the Quap's got a sheep. Slarker's coming in. They don't have enough. They gotta get out. Oh, the Slark's gonna turn it in. Death is just watching powerlessly as the Slark does whatever the fuck he wants. Oh my god, that was a hell of a fight. Hell of a fight. Helm of the Dominator, Soul Ring, Blink Dagger for the Enigma. That's all he needs. Just needs to get that black hole out. Sand King just got all of his damage on him, just still wasn't that much. Doesn't seem like. I don't even know how. They don't have a pipe or anything. Yeah, no pipe. So another, I'd say, lost fight for the Diver. They gotta win one of these fights one time. It's just requiring too much to kill the Slark and the Invoker. And the Enigma. I mean, they should ideally be able to kill a Disruptor in 3 hits. And I don't know what stopped him. I mean, he doesn't have Glimmer. He's getting the Glimmer now. Should be on the Courier. Yep. He's getting the Glimmer now, but it's not been there. So I don't know what's stopping him at all. We got a smoke from the Dire. Making this big plays to come back into the game here. Let's see what happens. We'll zoom out. Oh, we're gonna get the Clockwork caught. Oh my god, the stun misses, but the Eel's gonna dispel the haste. Doesn't have any haste anymore. They decide to go on the Disruptor. Disruptor down. Are they gonna do the Clockwork as well? Ooh, they need to watch the big re-engage here from Invoker. Do they not have a black hole? They don't have a black hole. This is a bad fight from the Invoker. The Sony Chrono. Oh my god, it's not enough. It is enough to get the Invoker. Clockwork hooking in, stopping that though. Radiant's throwing so hard. Dire's winning those big fights, baby. Here we go. Clockwork laughing. Not sure there's much to laugh about. When did this tier 3 tower go on? I think that. I don't know what happened to that tier 3 tower. But Dire's got some work to do here. That fight right there. We'll see more of it. But. Okay, there we go. Big fight XP wise. Less so gold, but still significant. If they could do another one, that would just be epic. So we do have Blink Force Yules now going for the Scepter. I love the Scepter on Sand King. So with Blink Force, okay, so Blink, you can blink from, you know, base essentially. So like say here, you can blink, you know, here's about the range, max range of Blink. Alright? Right there. Force Staff, you know, gets you about here, right? Fucking Scepter stun gets you right here, like if you stun the very edge of the target. So you can stun from essentially in about half a second, probably a second though. You can stun someone here all the way from back here. Pretty fucking crazy. We'll see if he can capitalize on it. Looks like Radiant is crumbling. My guess is the Invoker thinks he's the tough shit, flaming everyone. getting a Aeon disc.
I'll take your tribute.
I don't know about that. I mean, if he's dropping a fucking deafening blast meteor combo and his Aeon disc gets procced, that's like 1400 damage against every target in that AoE that's just not gonna take it. I mean, that's pretty significant if he can fucking do it. At the same time, if Invoker can live through the initial burst from the Dire, then he can turn around and basically control all of them. We've seen it already this game, so might be a really, really good purchase for him. He's definitely trying to save buybacks, so he's still about 1,000 shy of it. Got Scout from the Helm of the Dominator creep. Defi trying to push out top on the Queen of Pain. Too scared. This is where, like, we see all of them here, right? Like, we see all of them here. Defi should obviously push this lane one more time. But when your only vision's here, and they can access the jungle from here or over here, pushing that extra wave up here is scary as shit. Oh, mid, we got a huge fight. Oh my god, they're getting crazy. Void doesn't have anything. What the fuck's the Void doing? Oh man, Pop doesn't have anything either. Pop going down. Holy shit, bad engagement. I'm not sure what happened, but Void didn't have any mana. Got caught with the imp. He didn't even Black King Bar, though. Maybe a misstep. Quap has a fucking buyback, though. They could bait a huge fight here, and then buyback on the Quap and turn it. So we'll see what happens. Pushing the high grounds with the Dominated Creeps and the Edelons. Someone has to stop it. Alacrity on the Catapult. And they gotta fight, because that Barracks is going down in 2 seconds. Maybe not. Oh, and they knew he wasn't gonna want to use the PKD for it, so they just go on and bend bay. Wait, is he not? Oh, we can see the lag happening in this game, can't you? Holy crap. That's just crazy as fuck. Void's down. Void buys back. Chrono on one. It's the Invoker. Can they kill the Invoker? He gets black pulled by the Enigma. Enigma gets sheep. Invoker has his Andis proc. And Void's out in the middle of nowhere with nowhere to go. Radiant getting low. Dire lower, though. Dire can't really engage on this. Can they? They're turning. They're trying to turn. They get one. It's the Disruptor. They try to get the another. It's the Invoker. Oh, they dodged the... What do you call it? The Sunbeam shit, whatever the fuck it is. Sheep going on the Slark and they kill the Slark. They're trying to kill the Slark. Oh, and they stun. Pop getting killed. Ooh. Here we go. Slark trying to get the Witch Doctor as well. Enough to get the Witch Doctor. Stun from sinking does not connect. They needed that. Slaughter stun, however, will come out. They will kill the Enigma. Buyback from the Witch Doctor. Not sure that buyback was needed. We'll see if the Slark decides to continue. Slark decides to continue, but they can't do anything about it because the stun from the Sand King took him the other way. So I think we got, does fight recap show buybacks? Cold change. Wow. So technically a one buyback for the Dire. Or a one fight, I mean, because of the XP, but 13k gold lead staying. Ooh, XP's even right now. That's just juicy as fuck. 15k net worth advantage for the Radiant, though. Those Midases coming in. Better farming ability coming in. Invoker already has winning fights coming in. So Dire's gonna have to make some big plays here. They still have all tier 2s up, unfortunately. So there's no way to kind of win one fight and just go down one lane and get megas, or even get two laner racks. I mean, you're kind of stuck getting one laner racks if they can even do it. Which, I mean, Void's are only tower damage. Sand King going for a sheep as well. Slaughter has a Black King bar. I guess that'd be pretty big. Getting a four staff on the Witch Doctor. And Void going for Lincolns. Getting another defensive item. I feel like he just needs to commit with his BKB and use his BKB to fight. I mean, they're obviously right here. They tornadoed him up and they knew he wasn't going to BKB. So they just force staffed him forward, sheeped him. And they knew they were going to be able to do it because he didn't want to BKB for that. So if he would have BKB right when he got down and jumped on them, he could have gotten a two-man chrono and really gotten a favorable fight off. But it takes a lot to be able to expect that instantaneous, just knowing where they are or having faith that, you know, you are going to get a good engage. And we've got a smoke from the Dire. They know they're rushing. They do know they're rushing. Edelon's scouting, but they're not going to see the smoke. Dire wrapping around. Do they guess the rush? And they don't guess the rush. And do they back or they commit? They might want to commit anyways. Oh, we got a five-man going high ground, but they sheep him. Sinking ulti coming out. Sinking ulti getting on one. Just a disruptor. Disruptor doesn't have anything. And this is going to be a bad fight. Radiant's getting the big shit done. Oh, Clockwork's down already, though. Can Sinking dodge? Well, of course, if he does, they're going to make a lot of space. He doesn't. Sinking down. Meanwhile, Enigma going on the Stardart. Buyback from the Sand King. We got two down from the Radiant. Trying to get the Stardart. Stardart trying to dodge again. We have Starks going up solo here. Trying to kill two Dire heroes. What is going on? We got the Invoker killing the Stardart meanwhile. And, oh, the counter sheep. Oh, but there's no stun up. He's got the Yules, though. He doesn't Yules. Oh, no. He could have saved him with the Yules. Wishlock coming in. The Coconuts are going to bounce. Coconuts are bouncing. Oh, but it doesn't matter. This goes in for Slark killing him. Slark doing so much. Slark actually taking too much damage. Slark's going down. That's just the Aegis. Oh, man. Wishlock, they're getting hit pretty hard. Wishlock cannot survive the right clicks. And all Sink can do is sit there. He gets tornadoed on the way out. And this looks pretty over for the Dire. They won't be able to buy back at all. He gets sheep on the fourth step away. And that is looking pretty painful. Radiant pushing all dead for the Dire. And I think this is probably GG. It's a hard-fought game, but that Slark got way too big, and the teamfights just didn't seem to work out. The void was too much of a focus from the other team, and he was expected to also engage, I felt like. But I feel like they should have been using the same thing to engage rather than the Void. You know, it's tough. It's tough. I hate engaging with the Chrono. Engaging with the Chrono sucks. But we've got a game server overload.
With vim and vigor.
Okay, here we go. We got the scoreboard here. And I'd say the Invoker was probably the MVP there. Despite what Slark was doing, I think the Invoker just enabled all of that. And so, if I'd have to pick an MVP for the Dire, I don't know. I guess maybe Quap, but he just felt so limited. It just felt really tough for the Dire to do their thing. Oh my god, he was Crusader. Oh, they lost to a Crusader 4. That's brutal. Very brutal. Divine 4, Invoker. Probably playing his Comfort here that he plays all the time. Well, that was a close fought match from Minecraft Maniacs, eliminated in the semifinals of the Euro Battle Cup. And, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the cast. Maybe try to get another one in here, and catch y'all next time.